Hi all, welcome back. In today's lecture, we will be having a discussion about the network functions. In network function, we will discuss the concept of complex frequency and we will discuss system function or network function. Basically, in literature, the system function or the network function are synonymous to each other. And in system function, we will throw some light on driving point function and the transfer function. Basically, while you are talking about the driving point function and the transfer function, basically these terms are associated with one port network or two port network or n port network. So we will try to introduce the single port network as well as two port network also. Now let me come to our first concept, that is concept of complex frequency. I hope students you remember that in my last lecture we had a discussion about the transient analysis, and we solved the transient analysis with the help of differential equation. So if you remember, the general solution of differential equation is given by ft is equal to k e raised to power st. So this term s is important, which is for the complex number or the complex frequency. So what is the meaning of this s that we will discuss now? Technically, the s is given by sigma plus g omega. Now first let me discuss about this ft is equal to k e raised to power st. When we put s equal to sigma plus g omega, it comes like e raised to power sigma into t plus g omega into t. And I hope you know e raised to power a plus b can be written by e raised to power a into e raised to power b. In the very same fashion, we can write it like k e raised to power sigma t multiplied by e raised to power j omega t. So technically we are going to discuss about e raised to power sigma t. This sigma is the real part of s and appear as an exponential factor. Exponential factor means it will appear as e raised to power sigma t. The real part sigma decides the amplitude variation and appear as an exponential power in the time domain as e raised to power sigma t. I hope it is clear. Now the second is the omega, where omega is the imaginary part of s since j omega is associated, so it is imaginary part and it is in radian frequency, in radian per second. The omega appear in time domain as the frequency of the oscillatory term in the form of cos omega t or sin omega t. How you say that? If you say e raised to power j omega t, e raised to power j omega t can be represented by cos omega t plus j sin omega t. Hence we represent this e raised to power j omega t in oscillatory terms, cos omega t and sin omega t. Hence omega is called radian or the real frequency. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now, since s is a type of frequency that depends on two parameters, one is sigma, which controls the magnitude part of the signal, and the other is omega, which controls the rotation of the signal, is known as the complex frequency. Technically, if you are going to plot this s with respect to sigma and j omega, so this sigma is represented by the magnitude and j omega or omega represent the rotation of the signal. Okay. Now, let me discuss the physical significance of complex frequency that will depend upon the values of sigma as well as the g omega. There may be various cases, whether sigma is 0, whether g omega is 0, or whether both the sigma and g omega lie in the circuit. So let me say case 1. In the case 1, we have assumed that omega is equal to 0. So if you say k e raised to power sigma plus g omega into t and sigma is 0, in this case omega is 0, so this is k e raised to power sigma into t. Okay, so it will come like k e raised to power sigma into t. Done. Now sigma may be greater than 0, sigma may be less than 0, or sigma is equal to 0. So again, in this particular case there may be three cases. First is, when sigma is greater than 0, it will be exponentially increasing function. Second, when sigma is equal to 0, e raised to power 0 is 1, so it will be a constant, so it is a constant function. Okay, now the third is, when sigma is less than 0, sigma is less than 0, this is the negative value. So e raised to power minus some alpha into t, so this is a negative value, so it will be exponentially decaying function. So on the basis of sigma, we can plot, there will be three values. One is sigma greater than 0, exponentially increasing. Second, sigma equal to 0 means constant. And third is, sigma less than 0 means exponentially decaying. Okay, that is the case 1. Now in the case 2, if we say sigma is equal to 0 but omega exists in the circuit, so this is s equal to plus j omega. We have taken plus minus j omega, but let me consider plus j omega right now. So ft will be equal to k e raised to power j omega into t, and we can represent e की power j omega t as cos omega t plus j sin omega t. यहाँ पर j भी आएगा साथ में. ft will be equal to k into cos omega t plus j sin omega t. Now if we go, you know, this is a if we discuss about just cos omega t plus j sin omega t, it is a rectangular part, and we can represent this rectangular part into the polar part. So in the polar part, r angle theta, so r will be equal to, the magnitude will be equal to under root cos square omega t plus sin square omega t. Means this a square plus b square. So that will be under root cos square omega t plus sin square omega t, and the angle wise angle tan inverse y by x. Okay, the coefficient of j multiplied by, divided by the real part. So that will be sin omega t by cos omega t. So hence we can say this will be tan omega t. So here it will come omega t, and from trigonometry it is equal to 1. So we can say e to power j omega t is equal to 1 angle omega t. If we represent this e to power j omega t 1 angle omega t on real and imaginary axis, or you can see the phasor axis. So this says 1 is the constant part. Whatever will be the value of this omega t, its magnitude will always be equal to 1. So technically this is a unit circle, and in this unit circle the omega t is the variable, and this will be the angle of this rotation. So this angle omega t is the angle of the rotation, and I hope you understand that omega t is taken into anti-clockwise direction. So this omega t is positive when we are taking it in anti-clockwise direction. Now let me say we are talking about the e raised to power minus j omega t. So the value will come as 1 angle minus omega t, and we will rotate this value in clockwise direction. Magnitude will still be same as equal to 1, but it will represent in clockwise direction, that is 1 angle minus omega t. Okay, let me discuss the case third. In the case third, why we are saying s equal to sigma plus j omega, we can write ft is equal to k e to power sigma plus j omega into t. It will be k e to power sigma t multiplied by e to power j omega t. Now this is the real part and this is the imaginary part. Now see, technically ft is a function of multiplication of two time dependent functions. One is e to power sigma t and another is e to power j omega t. Let me see. You can see e to power j omega t is equal to cos omega t plus j sin omega t. So there may be different values according to the sigma and according to the omega. Let me see, if we consider sigma is greater than 0, then it will be exponentially increasing. But if we are saying sigma is less than 0, then it will be exponentially decaying. So technically, while you are saying the plotting of e to power sigma t into sin omega t, the curve will follow the path of the sin omega t. So if we start from t equal to 0 means 0, if we start from t equal to 0, the only difference is it will follow the exponentially increasing path. It will follow the exponentially increasing path because it is multiplied by e to the power sigma t, where sigma is greater than 0 and it is exponentially increasing. Okay. In the second case, while you are saying e to the power sigma t sin omega t, here sigma is less than 0, so it is exponentially decaying. So while you are going to plot sin omega t like this, it will follow the sin theta graph, but it is exponentially decaying function. Okay, so it will eventually die out at when t tend to infinity. In the very same fashion, we have plotted cos e raised to power sigma t into cos omega t and e raised to power sigma t into cos omega t when sigma is greater than 0 or sigma is less than 0. It will exponentially increasing, it will exponentially decreasing. The only thing is it will follow the cos theta graph, because here we are saying cos omega t, so it will follow the cos omega t graph. I hope it is clear. Fine. Okay. Now let me discuss the system function or the network function. You know, in different literature, it is very well defined. The system function is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of output variable, means you are talking about the response, to the Laplace transform of input variable, means you are talking about the excitation, assuming all initial conditions equal to 0. I hope you remember in transient analysis we had a number of initial conditional discussion. But here, while you are saying the system function or the network function, we assume that all the initial conditions are equal to 0. Now, if we say HS is equal to network function, RS is Laplace transform of input variable, and CS is Laplace transform of output variable. So HS is given by CS by RS. So technically it is a ratio of output by input, in the Laplace domain B, the only thing is we have assumed that the initial conditions will be equal to 0. Please do not confuse, because in different books CS, RS or HS may be represented by some other notation. For example, in some books the output is represented by YS, the input is represented by US. So there will be different notations, so don't confuse with that. Okay. Now let me discuss about the one port and two port network. As we said earlier, technically if you are saying any port network, if you are saying any network, so any network can be represented by a black box. Okay, any network can be represented by a black box, and a pair of terminal connected to such a black box at which a signal may enter the network or leave the network is called a port. Okay, this is the network. It may be some combination of resistance, inductance, capacitance, or maybe some other circuit element. But if we are saying the signal will enter or signal will leave the black box, that is called the port. Technically, while you are talking about the one port network, it will be having one port only. But when you are saying the two port network, it will be having two port, 11 and 22 dash. Okay. The variable associated with each port are voltage and current. Whenever we are having a discussion about the network analysis and synthesis, normally we discuss about the voltage and current only. Okay, the one port networks are used practically as a load. Basically here we can supply something, so this will behave like a load only. But while you are talking about the two port network, we have given some values input and we have got some value as the output. So on the basis of the impedance of this network, or you can see the characteristics of this network, it will take some input value and it will provide some output value. Okay, so that will transform the information. Now, network function called one port network. Technically, you are talking about the one port and a two port network in our syllabus. So, network function are applicable for one port network. For the one port network, two variables are measured at the same port. When you are saying we are having the same port and we are having the voltage, we are having the current. So, whatever variable you are talking about, that will be measured only on one port. Okay. Now technically if you say we are having two network functions, one is called a driving point impedance function, second is called a driving point admittance function. So driving point means we are talking about the same port. So here we are having just one port, so it will be ZS, and ZS will be equal to VS by IS. VS is here and IS is here. Since we are having a single port, so we represent VS by IS. Or driving point admittance function, so YS is equal to IS by VS, and we are talking about this port only. Okay, so as far as concerned about the one port network, we are having just two things. First is driving point impedance function, second is driving point admittance function, then is equal to the voltage applied divided by the current, or the current flowing through the branch upon the voltage applied in the case of admittance. Okay, now move on. Network function for two port network. Now actually this is important, because a number of times these things are asked in the numerical also. So first is driving point at impedance function. Now for a two port network, while you are saying the meaning of driving point impedance function, we discussed earlier that while you are saying driving point, it means we are talking about the same port. So whether that is a 11 port or the 22 dash port, it is the same port. And driving point impedance function can be represented by Z11 for the first port or Z22 for the second port. Hence Z11S will be equal to V1S by I1S, or Z22S will be equal to V2S by I2S, since it is the impedance, it must be voltage by current. Okay, and as far as concerned about 11, it represents the driving point values. Okay. Now second is driving point admittance function. In the very same fashion, Y11S will be equal to admittance function at port 1, that is equal to I1 by V1S, and Y22S will be equal to I2S by V2S, the admittance function at the port 2. Okay. Now the next in two port network is transfer function. Now the difference between the driving point function and the transfer function is, while you are saying the driving point function, you are talking about the same port, but while you are talking about the transfer function, you are talking about the both the port. Now there are different parameters, so you can say different ratios. The first ratio is voltage ratio transfer function, and voltage ratio can be given by GS that is equal to V2S by V1S or V1S by V2S. That is called the voltage ratio. Okay. So that is called V2S by V1S or V1S by V2S. If it is G21S, then it will be V2S by V1S, or if it is G12S, it is V1S by V2S. In the very same fashion, it is given a current ratio transfer function. In current ratio transfer function, it will be given by alpha, and it is I2S by I1S or I1S by I2S. If I12S, then that is I1S by I2S, or if I alpha 21S, it is I2S by I1S. And since it is a ratio, it is not having any unit. Now the next is transfer impedance function. Important. Now transfer impedance function means एक पोर्ट का वोल्टेज और दूसरे पोर्ट का करंट. ओके, सो मींस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट V2S बाय I1S और वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट V1S बाय I2S. सो इफ इट इज Z21S, वी विल से V2S बाय I1S. इफ इट इज Z12S, इट विल से V1S बाय I2S. सो मींस वन पोर्ट का नेटवर्क, वन पोर्ट का वोल्टेज और दूसरे पोर्ट का करंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसफर इंपीडेंस. वी आर ट्रांसफरिंग सम इंफॉर्मेशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसफर इंपीडेंस. V2S by I1 or V1S by I2S. In the very same fashion, transfer admittance function is Y21 means I2S by V1S or Y12S means I1S by V2S. And I hope you understand why you are talking about I1S, I2S, V1S, V2S, Z12S, Z21S, all are the Laplace transform value. Okay, let me go to our next thing. Oh, very important. This is a pole and zero. There must be a very small discussion about the pole and zero. In larger term, I will discuss in the next lecture. As far as concerned about pole and zero, we took that HS. HS was the system function that can be represented by the ratio of two polynomials. Earlier, we represented that CS by RS. Now, we are going to represent this HS equal to PS by QS. Okay, where PS is the numerator and QS is the denominator, and since both are the polynomial in S, it can be represented by HS equal to A naught S raised to power m plus A1 S raised to power m minus 1 plus A2 S raised to power m minus 2 plus 1 plus An divided by B naught S to power n plus B1 S to power n minus 1 plus B2 S to power n minus 2 plus 1 Dn. Technically, the order of the PS is m and the order of S is n in this condition. Okay, now it may be possible you are talking about a polynomial in S in both the things, and there must be some rules. So we have represented in the rules. So here HS is equal to K into S minus Z1, S minus Z2, so on, S minus Zm, and in the denominator part it is S minus P1, S minus P2, so on, S minus Pn. We have Z1, Z2, Z3, so on, Zm represent the zeros of the system, and S equal to P1, P2, P3, so on, Pn represent the pole of the system. Technically, when you are saying the roots of the polynomial PS equal to 0, so PS equal to 0, so it means they are the roots, zeros are the roots of the polynomial PS equal to 0. In the very same fashion, P1, P2, P3, so on, Pn are the roots of the QS equal to 0. In at last, this K is called system gain factor or scale factor. Okay, this constant K is called the system gain factor or scale factor. Now, everybody is clear? Now, see, these two things are very important. We are going to discuss about the necessary condition for driving point function and necessary condition for transfer function. So, I hope you will bear this in your mind. While we are saying driving point function, it means one port only. Means V1 by V2 or V2 by, means, V1 by I1 or V2 by I2 with the same port. But when you are talking about the driving point function, it is always V1 by V2 or V2 by V1, I1 by I2 or I2 by I1. Technically, we have to transfer the information. So that is called the transfer function. Now, the necessary condition for both the driving point function and the transfer function are almost same. They are a little bit different. Just let me discuss about that. So the first condition is, the coefficient of the numerator polynomial PS and the denominator polynomial QS must be real and positive. So let me see from the previous. These are the PS and QS, and these are the coefficient A0, A1, A2, so on, AM in PS, or we are saying B0, B1, B2, so on, Bn. These are the coefficients, and we are saying all the coefficient of the polynomial Ps and Qs must be real and positive. Okay, so all the coefficient must be real and positive. Now, condition 2, if pole and geos are imaginary, then such pole and geos must be conjugate. It is a well understood thing that whenever any element exists in imaginary part, it always comes up with the conjugate pair. Okay, and we are talking about the pole and zeros. So technically, we said that the roots of Ps are the zeros, and the roots of Qs are the poles. So there may be that S equal to Z1, Z2, Z3, so on Zm, or S equal to P1, P2, P3, so on Pn. Then we have either it is the real, either it is imaginary, or either it is equal to zero. So right now we are having a discussion if these roots are imaginary, they will always come up in the pair. Okay, they will always come up in pair. Now the third is the real part of all the poles and zeros must be negative or zero. And if the real part is zero, then the poles or zeros must be simple. So it is very important. Just try to understand. We are saying the real part of, now let me say S equal to Z1, or let me say S equal to P1. So Z1 and P1 are the poles. And if we are saying Z1 is equal to 2, Z1 equal to minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 7, that is completely okay. If you are saying P1 equal to minus 3, minus 5, minus 6, minus 8, that is completely okay. But if we are saying Z1 or P1 is equal to some positive value, means having some positive real part, that is not a good sign. It must not be positive at all, because in that case the stability of the system vanish. Okay, so all the roots must lie in the left half of S plane, that is for the stability. Now in this case, one important part has been also given, that if the real part is zero, then the poles or zeros must be simple. So it means if real part is zero, then of course the pole or zero must be imaginary, and imaginary pole or zeros must be simple. Means either it will be J2 and minus J2, but it will never be J2 and J2 and minus J2 and minus J2. Means there must be a single pole zero. There must be a single conjugate pole. There must not be two conjugate poles at the same value. Okay. Now the next part is, there should not be any missing term between the highest and lowest degree in the polynomial Ps and Qs unless all the even or odd terms are missing. Very important part. We are saying that from S raised to power m to S raised to power 0 or S raised to power n to S raised to power 0, there must not be any missing term in the polynomial Ps or Qs. For example, if we are having a polynomial in which S raised to power 5 plus 4 S to power 4 plus 3 S cube plus 7 S square plus 16 S plus 20 is equal to 0, then the polynomial, then what we are saying, trying to say that there must not be any missing term. Means S raised to power S to power 5 say S to power 0 tak koi bhi missing term nahi honi chahiye. Pehla cheez. Dusra, agar aisa hota nahi hai ki koi missing term, agar koi term missing hai, so the polynomial should be even or the polynomial should be odd. It means all the even terms should be equal to 0 and all the odd terms should be equal to 0. Then only the polynomial will exist. Okay. So that is a very important condition. Now the next is, the degree of the polynomial in numerator and denominator should differ by either 0 or 1 only. Okay. So while you are talking about the numerator by denominator, so the degree of the polynomial in numerator and denominator should differ by either 0 or 1 only. Iska matlab hai, numerator and denominator ki jo degrees hai, usme sirf 0 ya 1 ka difference hona chahiye, usse zyada ka difference nahi ho sakta. Okay, otherwise the system will be unstable. And now the last part is, the terms of lowest degree and in Ps and Qs may differ in degrees at the most by 1. Okay, pehle we were talking about the highest degree, now we are talking about the lowest degree. The terms of lowest degree in Ps and Qs may differ in degree at the most by 1 only. Iska matlab hai, agar Ps ki degree 4 hai aur Qs ki degree 5 hai, that is completely okay. Agar Ps ki degree 4 hai aur Qs ki degree 3 hai, it is still okay. बट पीएससी डिग्री अगर चार है और क्यूएससी डिग्री दो है, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, इट मस्ट नॉट बी डन. ओके, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द ड्राइविंग पॉइंट फंक्शन, नेसेसरी कंडीशन फॉर द ड्राइविंग पॉइंट फंक्शन. नाउ लेट मी डिस्कस अबाउट नेसेसरी कंडीशन फॉर द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट बोथ आर द फंक्शंस एक्चुअली इन सम लाप्लास डोमेन, अज्यूमिंग ऑल इनिशियल कंडीशंस इक्वल टू जीरो. सो वन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन ट्रांसफर फंक्शन ऑफ द one important part in the transfer function or in the driving point function is that after cancelling the common factor in the polynomial PS and QS, so whatever the leftover polynomial is we are talking about, that is leftover polynomial. So the necessary condition for the transfer function are as follows. The first one is the coefficient of PS and QS must be real and conjugate, as we discussed earlier. Second is the complex and imaginary poles and GOs must be conjugate, as we discussed earlier. Third, the real part of poles must be negative or zero, and if it is zero, the pole must be simple including origin. Please try to understand, in the previous part we discussed about the poles and zeros must be negative or zero. In this transfer function we are more interested about the poles only, because technically if you go by the stability analysis, it says that the stability of the system largely depend upon the location of the poles only. Hence we are saying the real part of the poles must be negative or zero, and if it is zero, the pole must be simple including origin. Okay, now the next part is there should not be any missing term between the highest and lowest degree of QS unless all the even or all the odd terms are missing. Still we are talking about the QS, means QS means the poles. So the very same, in the very same fashion as we discussed earlier, in the QS there must not be any missing term from the highest to lowest. और अगर कोई टर्म मिसिंग होती भी है तो ऑल द इवन और ऑल द ऑड टर्म्स में भी मिसिंग. ओके, द नेक्स्ट इज द पॉलिनोमियल पीएस मे हैव नेगेटिव टर्म्स और इवन सम मिसिंग टर्म्स बिटवीन द हाईएस्ट एंड द लोएस्ट डिग्री. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द जीरोस नाउ. सो इन जीरोस सम कंडीशंस मे नॉट बी एप्लीकेबल, एंड वी आर सेइंग द पॉलिनोमियल पीएस मे हैव सम नेगेटिव टर्म्स. मींस इफ वी आर सेइंग द पीएस इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय a not s to power m plus a1 s to power m minus 1 plus a2 s to power m minus 2 plus 1 am. So that was the our zeros. So in this a not a1 a2 so on am, so some terms may be negative or even some terms may be missing between the highest and the lowest degree. It doesn't create any offense while you are saying the transfer function, but we are more interested about the poles of the system. So the last is the degree of polynomial ps must be as small as zero, independent of the degree of the polynomial QS. Okay, so polynomial PS, polynomial PS represents the zeros. So zeros aapka constant bhi ho sakta hai, zeros aapka 1 degree bhi ho sakta hai aur 2 degree bhi ho sakta hai. It is independent of the degree of the polynomial QS. But the QS, we are more important about the QS, means the poles of the system. Okay, so I hope in this lecture we discuss about the complex frequency, we discuss about the one pole and two pole network, we discuss about the necessary conditions for the driving point function and the transfer function, and I hope it is clear. In my next lectures we will be having a discussion about the numerical part now. Okay, take care, bye bye.